ang daming nasasayangan kung bakit why Michelle Gumabao did not win Miss Universe Philippines 2020. It's because most of us medyo nag-expect na si Michelle Gumabao ang mananalong Miss Universe Philippines. Ang isang reason is this. Ayan. So, as you can see, she is wearing the crown, yung Miss Universe Philippines crown. And kung titignan nyo, okay naman pala yung crown, di ba? Hindi siya masyadong malaki, just like what this picture tells us. And nung pinatong sa ulo ni Michelle Gumabao, I'm not sure if that is an edited picture or talagang rehearsal lang, part of the rehearsal, but it looks good, o diba? It looks good on her. And that time when I saw Michelle Gumabao wearing that crown, I thought na siya yung talagang na-leak na nanalo. However, yun po ang hindi nangyari. So we will be discussing 5 reasons why Michelle Gumabao did not win Miss Universe Philippines 2020. And this is your host. My name is Anthony. And we will now start with the first reason. So, perception ko lang to. You are free to suggest. And number one is that it is not yet her time, or it's not her time yet to win Miss Universe Philippines. Why? Because I believe in the saying na if it's your time, it's your time. If it's not your time, it's not your time. So, in Michelle Gumabao's case, obviously, it is not yet her time to shine or time to represent the Philippines. Although, she is one of the most prepared candidate in this batch, in this first edition of Miss Universe Philippines. Kasi, even if you all have the recipe to win or to clamor for something, meron at meron yung 1% na yun yung time. Kaya, yes, hindi natin yun matawag dito, makukuha, or hindi natin inaasahan talaga na mangyayari. And that's how it's been, or that is how it's supposed to be. O diba, nakuha ko yung correct word. Anyway, yung final answer, that's the second part. Very spontaneous, so hindi ko nasasabihin yung direct na sinabi niya sa Q&A. But then, in my own perception sa final answer niya, is really on point, very spontaneous, very concise. Ang daming laman ng final answer niya. So, in my own perception, baka siguro hindi, parang nakukulangan pa ng timpla. The judges are still waiting for that boom statement na gusto nilang marinig kay Michelle. However, syempre, if they are not convinced with your answer, so they will not be giving the perfect score, yung katulad ng nangyari kay Gabia Mateo. And one thing na napansin ko is, syempre, sa kaka-rehearse mo sa Q&A during your trainings, parang ayun na, natimpla, and then napunta na sa actual na pageant, which is dapat from the heart, o diba? Although from the heart din kay Michelle, pero mas from the heart kasi yung answer ni Rabia Mateo. So, please don't bash me for this statement. Ayan, that's only my perception. You are free to comment or suggest yung kung ano yung masasabi nyo dito sa feedback ko. So, let's proceed sa third. Ayan. And andito yung confidence factor. Michelle Gumabao is obviously the most prepared. Ayan. So, binanggit ko na naman ulit. And here comes the confidence factor. She is well prepared pagdating sa Q&A. Ayan. Lahat ng question. She knows how to analyze. She knows how to formulate the right statement, words, ideas, yung mga reference, yung pag-atake, yung strategy, how to answer that question. She knows how to well answer it in her own way. So, syempre, basing from her experience as a host, as a previous pageant contestants, and from yung mga advices ng kanyang camp. Ayun. So, in my own also na analysis, siguro dahil sa pagiging confident niya sa sagot niya, merong sigurong lapses na parang nakalimutan niya atang i-consider na ayun, doon nagkaroon ng problema. So, she might as well going to review it again, make another assessment so that titignan niya kung ano nga ba yung part sa pageant kung saan nagkaroon ng gap. So, that's the third reason, yung confidence factor. And then, yung pang-fourth, yung exposure. Since the beginning ng Miss Universe Philippines, nung nagpirma siya ng contract as an official candidate for Miss Universe Philippines, ayan, as in, umusbong na yung balita about sa kanya. Alam niyo yon, talagang nag-boom yung social media about sa kanya, yung attention. So basically, there is parang medyo mataas yung kanyang exposure, parang yung attention ng pageant fans is nakatutok sa kanya. As well as kay Alyssa Malinaw. So, siya and Alyssa ang pinakamatunog na candidate from the start until the end. Kaya, pag maririnig mo yung Michelle Gumabaw or yung Miss Universe Philippines, andun palagi yung nasa isip mo na si Michelle Gumabaw. So, ganon. However, sa kakaabang kay Michelle Gumabaw, parang nawala yung excitement, parang ganon. Parang na-over kasi yung exposure sa kanya, so parang naumay na yung mga ibang fans. Kaya ganon yung isang reason, parang yung there is a downward trend, yung parang excitement dahil sa exposure na yon. So, I guess, siguro that is another reason kung bakit parang na bawasan na ng excitement. Ayun, excitement ako ng excitement. And then, yung pang-fifth is, oops, ayan, nag-alaw ko. Yung pang-fifth is yung glam team factor. Siguro, it is time for her to change her glam team kung ano man yung current na nag-handle sa kanya. Ganun kasi yung usually na trend or yung mga ginagawa ng mga ibang beauty queens, lalong-lalo na if they will decide again to participate in another national pageant. So, parang yung ginawa ni Mary Jean, ni MJ Lastimosa, ni Pia Words. I'm not sure kay Pia Words back, parang feeling ko same kay Pia Words back. But kay MJ Lastimosa, nag-change siya ng glam team niya nung sumali siya ng ilang beses sa Miss Binibining Pilipinas and clinched the round. So, might as well, baka siguro, same as yung number one, yung hindi sa kanya yung time, yung glam team factor, baka, alam niyo yon, kung mahilig kayo sa superstition, ayun, might as well, you will consider changing your current routine into another routine, changing of yung mga environment, yung mga ganon. So, that is my fifth na reason. And I would like to say congratulations Michelle Gumabaw for placing as the second runner-up for Miss Universe Philippines 2020. Tapos, di ba, naalala niyo yung picture na wala siya during sa after pageant na press conference at ayon, if I'm not mistaken. Wala si Michelle doon. So, nouna pala siyang bumaba. So, bumalik siya sa kanyang place, sa kanyang home, and she broke her silence, yung alleged na walkout issue, wherein she's already contented na syempre magpa-place as second runner-up, which is not an easy thing to do na mag-place ka ng second runner-up in a national pageant competition, and she is happy for what she achieved in this pageant because second runner-up is already a big accomplishment. And congratulations Michelle for being brave, for being one of the stars of the competition. And I have a strong feeling na Michelle Gumabaw will again join. Siguro kung hindi sa Miss Universe Philippines 2021, baka sa ibang pageant na sa Miss World Philippines, Miss Earth, ayan, or even babalik sa Binibining Pilipinas. Ayan, kasi nga, 'di ba, bata pa siya and she still has more na maipapakita in terms of pageantry. And since it is still in pandemic, marami pa rin cases ng pandemic, kaya imposible magiging back to normal tayo. So, it will be an opportunity for Michelle to continue her dream to become a representative of the Philippines for Miss Universe, baka magiging successor pa siya ni Rabia Mateo. So that's it for my 5 reasons why Michelle Gumabaw failed to win Miss Universe Philippines 2020 and placed as the second runner-up. So if you want more vlogs like this, subscribe to my YouTube channels, guys. Subscribe for more updates like this. And comment down below kung ano yung mga gusto yung suggestions, comment, feedbacks, and reach me out in my Facebook page, Instagram, or Twitter, The Story of Anthony Daniel, aking name or profile. So, thank you guys. I hope may natutunan kayo dito. And stay safe. God bless you all.